Hello and welcome to another video on my AJP PR7. Today I'm going to take the fuel injector apart and have a look at the little filter that's on top of the fuel injector. Take the filter out, clean it, put it back, be done with it. So why would you want to take this apart? Well, first of all, your bike has to be running poorly. And secondly, you've been filling up, fueling up with some dodgy fuel. I mean, those are the reasons for taking the fuel injector apart. Well, it's important that you do this with the tools that you carry with you on the trail. So I use my toolkit that I carry with me all the time. And I tell you what I'm using as we go along. First of all, let's remove the seat and then take the number 8 to take the plastic panels apart. The fuel pipe, filler pipe, connects to this rubber seal here, and let's have a look. We can use a screwdriver to loosen this, or use what seems to be number 6 or 7 socket. Let me have a look. That's a number 7. All right, with the Allen bolts removed and the rubber seal loosened up, we should be able to remove this whole filler pipe. All right, with the gas tank sealed here with a paper towel. I noticed that we still don't have access to the fuel injector. Actually, the air box needs to come off as well. So that's what I'm gonna do now, take the air box off. What we see here right now is the throttle body. And I will use a flashlight to shine a bit more light on it. Here we have a little nut, and that nut is holding the injector in place. So we need to take that nut loose. But before we do that, we need to release the hose from the hose going to the fuel injector. There's a nice quick release that we can use, and I'll show you that right here. We wipe that off a bit and then use the quick release here to cut the fuel line. It's going to spill some fuel, I'm sure, and probably it's gonna get right in my eyes. Let me put this piece of cloth underneath it and open it up. There we go. So this is the hose going down to the fuel injector, which goes in here below the throttle body. So now let's take this nut loose. So it's not so easy to get to this one. So make sure that the tools you bring with you on the trail actually fit in here. I have a little wrench and a socket. Let's see if it fits. All right, got it loose. Let's do the rest of my hands and try not to lose the nut somewhere in the engine. Okay, there we go. There is the nut.
Before being able to pull the fuel injector off, we need to take the connector loose. Let me try to take the connector loose and take the injector out.
After a small surgical procedure, I managed to take the injector out. There we go. Got a little fuel hose still attached, which I can take loose. Now comes the tricky part of taking the filter out. And I'm going to show you that now. First of all, what you need is a screw. You need a relatively thick and short screw, so that should be part of your toolkit, the one that you bring along on the trail. So let's take that out. So here's the screw. It's pretty thick, and not very long. If it's too long, you're going to go right through the filter, and that's no good. So we're going to screw the screw in one turn and try to pull the little filter out. There we go. Here's our tiny little filter, and that one needs to be cleaned out. Let's take the little filter and dump it in some clean fuel. Let's just leave it in there for a while. Let's just let it soak in. And then comes the part of blowing it out. I don't have an air compressor, and you're unlikely to have one out in the field. So we'll just try to blow some air through it with our lips, and hopefully that will clean it out. Here I was going to show you how to blow the injector filter out, but unfortunately the battery of my camera died and that footage has been lost. So I cannot show you that, it's gone. But it's pretty straightforward. You just take that little injector filter and put it between your lips and blow hard, and that will get rid of all the dirt. You can use an air compressor if you have one. Just be careful not to lose that tiny little filter. And yeah, there you go. Do that and put it all back together. Simple as that. So now that we've got our air filter back in place, we got our fuel filler nozzle back in place, the injector is back, we've got the fuel hose connected, should be good to go. Let's put the plastics back on there in the seat, take it for a test drive. And that's how we do the fuel injector. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Bye.